They're coming for you now.
They're coming.
They're coming to get you.
Hold your heavy strike. Hold it. Hold the heavy strike. Hold your heavy strike. Unleash the sword.
The corpse waved through itself over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from the land of shining fields. Their memorial stone is sacred. Come not here in the sun. Come not with a sword. Come not crying over a naked corpse. Come not with disturbed mind.
Do you hear the suffering, Senua? Does your precious gift of sight let you see the souls that rot here in this sea of corpses? Do you feel the blood running cold on your skin? Do you hear their endless cries? Do you smell their putrid wounds? They were once brothers, sisters, and loved ones. And look at what you have done to them. All because you were a coward, because you ran from your curse instead of facing it. When you turned your back on your father, Zinbel, you turned your back on the gods and let the darkness wreak havoc on your people. Why must they pay for your heresy?
Life and it will take you. It's taking you further and further into it.
Surrender to the darkness.
Darkness is here.
Thank you.
dear beloved Maw was powerless against the darkness when it came for her. She too had a sight. She too doubted the gods and let the darkness infest her. But she didn't run. She escaped the only way she knew how. She gave her life to the gods.
If only you had done the same, the world would have been spared this horror.
It's not.
Finish this!
Why do you still fight on? Maybe you too should suffer with your brethren in this rot and let your blood seep into the seas and the rivers of hell. Isn't that what you deserve after all you've done? Give the darkness what it wants, let it swallow your soul and destroy all that you are. Why are you fighting for someone who is already dead? Just look around you. What hope is there for you, even if a soul could be rescued? Do you think he'd thank you for what you have done to him, to his friends, to his father?
She gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother, to go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua, look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said it. I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong.
Zimbal was right. Everyone will suffer.
Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me? Do you still believe in me, Senua? In us?
Come back to me. Please. Don't let this darkness come between us.
The hardest battles are fought in the mind. He gave her the sword with which to fight in more ways than one. And she gave him her word, never to surrender. All she needed was a little help, a little hope.
Does she know her way into the mountain?
She's a good girl. Oh, isn't she?
So clever.
Did you miss us?
Oh, she did.
She did. Are you glad we're back?
She's so glad we're back. Go on.
There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf Rein. But Rein does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Rein's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Rein's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
Feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
No, go in. Don't
turn back.
What's it?
great beast guards Helheim. Gram is its name, and it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How will you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me.
Then do it. The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Senua.
It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate.
It's a trap.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do. Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them. But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and that they want me with them. That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't
listen. Do you see them?
Do you see their faces? He's coming. Senua, help me. Help, get me out of here. Don't go.
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
Take it. It'll keep you safe.
The room.
light will guide you.
Rain the dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rain would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rain reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rain go in search of Fafnir. The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
Yes.
Of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night, the faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
Did I? I don't remember. I was only five. They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
Go through the door.
We will find her.
She'll get her mother out.
Her mother
It's a trap. The beast is coming. Stupid baby.
Run away from the beast!
In though while you pined for Dillion. Do you remember that darkness, Senua? The beast is bringing it back.
Mother, why did you leave me? Spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Dillion. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dillion.
The beast is down there.
No, no.
She knows the beast is down there.
She keeps going towards
him. He's always
where are you watching you.
You're never safe from him.
You can feel him.
Be careful.
She needs to find Dillion.
Where is he?
She needs to find it. She lost it and she has to find it.
Where is it? Where is it?
The torch alight.
Just stop.
Take him down!
Take him down! Take him down.
Zinbel was trying to save her from the darkness. But she wouldn't listen.
Never disappeared.
And now everybody is dead.
Because of her. It's got her fault.
All her fault's weak.
So weak. She should have known. She should have.
Why doesn't she learn? When will she learn? Now the darkness has Dillion's.
And it will take it and never give it back.
She can search and search, but she will never find it.
She's let the darkness in. It's the end.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
She can't resist. Pointless even trying to retrieve it. She's lost.
Where is she going? She's got to go deeper to find the head. Deeper towards the darkness.
The beast is there. The beast is luring her deeper, deeper into the darkness. Deep down.
The beast has the head.
She's got the head. She will be trapped.
What's she doing?
She's lighting. She's making light.
She's
making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe. What's her plan? What's she thinking?
Help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Though Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
I can smell your blood.
No!
sleeping with him.
Turn your back on me. That is why Dillion will rot in hell. Come into my shadow.
Oh!
people think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand. Cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals. Kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. But maybe Dillion would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time, she can't save her own.